Hello, comic fans, here's Al Grey with another video in which I will ramble about art books by cartoonists, by different cartoonists, European cartoonists. And this is some kind of overview video here, even though I will go into depth and detail about this art book here by Brechtwenz and about the one by Lorenzo Matotti, and of course this art book by Rosin Fairfield, which he sent to me. But I can't go into detail about these beautiful books here, all published by the Galerie Daniel Magin. This one here about the European artist Will, called Mirage. And all these books, he's the creator of, or yeah, drew a Tiff Etendu for a long time. And this is a combination of artist edition, art book, wonderfully reprinted, wonderfully made stuff, all these books here. And they really deserve lots more care and attention that I could give them in this one video here. But given that you ever have read something by Will, some of his comics, you will, you will love this book here. And it shouldn't bother you if you can read French or not. And this is a common thing for all these ones. My French is very, very rusty at best, so I can figure out a sentence, the meaning of a sentence after a while, but I can't read a whole book. But it's actually, it shouldn't bother you, because these books here are all about the art. And I will cover Tiff Etendu, of course, and then I will come back to this beauty for sure. I can recommend all these Daniel Magin books, but maybe my favorite of them, as far as I've looked through them, is this one here about Maurice Tillieu, Heroic, after the first, I guess, publisher that put out stuff by Maurice Tillieu. Look at this. How imaginative these books are made is astonishing. And this has, again, a bit of everything, and a Maurice Tillieu video will come up pretty soon. So, that was the page I was looking for here, one of these pages. They do this several times with a translucent overlay with the color guide by Maurice Tillieu. So, and this book I've shown you already in my top 50 video, because this book was done recently in 2021. So, gave me the opportunity to include this beautiful book here in that list. Kind of a reprint of a sketchbook by Cosset, or I got the impression of several sketchbooks by Cosset, the Swiss cartoonist. And last but not least, Thibé, the creator, the cartoonist behind Ricochet, or Rick Master over here in Germany. And this is very exciting as well, even though Thibé is very conservative and deliberately unexciting cartoonist, but I mean this really in a positive sense. He doesn't go for the effects, but tell stories. And great book as well. But now, all these books aside, including the François Skuyten book that I've shown you in the last video, I can now focus on Brechtwenz and Lorenzo Matotti, the these two beautiful books out of the series of travel guides or travel books. So this is the travel book by Lorenzo Matotti about Vietnam. Of course, a series of sketches, drawings and paintings done in Vietnam. Lots of his signature painting style with oil crayons or wax pencils or however. He did this multi-layered stuff here, sometimes a bit reminding me of the technique done by François Coyten that I shown you in the last video. But lots of, for Matotti, rather unusual black and white stuff here as well. But here you have very prime Lorenzo Matotti there, right there. Lots of eye candy for sure. And if you're a fan of Lorenzo Matotti, this has to be actually a no-brainer to get the book here. This has been maybe the inspiration for Galandia. Now I see this here, and this is, of course, the drawing slash painting that was used for the cover. It actually doesn't matter which page you're looking at, it's always beautiful. And look at the stuff here. Or even some unfamiliar stuff, unusual stuff for Lorenzo Matotti, at least. So, very glad to have picked up this one here. But actually, of all the three books that I got so far from this Louis Vuitton line, this is my favorite. Just a personal thing, obviously, but this is a lot messier than the Lorenzo Matotti one, for an example. Very colorful, feels almost like a preparation sketch book for Brecht Evans' most recent gorgeous book, The City of Belgium, even though this is about Brussels. No, this is not about Brussels, this is about Paris. But The City of Belgium is actually homage to, yeah, the big cities, and could be Berlin, if you ask me, as well. But this is, of course, very specifically about this wonderful city of Paris. And very messy in parts, like I said, it very rough sketches, watercolors like Brecht Evans does. I mean, he uses many techniques. What watercolors are the most outstanding there? You're quickly sucked in into this world of colors and experimentation that is going on here. And here we go into the Louvre. Of course, there's no narration, but you could say this is the document of one very long, spirited visit of Paris. So it's a combination of loose sketches and more refined sketches. And if you have ever been to Paris, maybe you have experienced the same, like me, to feel as the, yeah, the person with the least fashionable clothing, the with the worst clothes in within a square mile. But that's actually a thing that I really always enjoyed in Paris. Yeah. To feel really like the ugly, clumsy German that I am. So, yeah, and well, one of the, if not the most beautiful museums in the world, it's one of the most original, the Centre Georges Pompidou. And pretty beautiful and imaginative and decorative. rendition of this museum. And one of my favorite places in the world here is this place with a fountain by Jean Tinguely and Niki de Saint-Phalle. Great to see this sort of mentioned here, and metro station. Museum of Natural Science. This book here is so full of fantastic and highly enjoyable stuff. That it's just a wonderful eye candy, and really a treat. And this is, of course, sort of a copy of a famous painting by Balthus. So, I mean, yeah, whether you like this kind of sketchy, messy, colorful art or not, this is, I guess, the key point to decide if you want this book here or not. But for me, who can't get enough of Brecht Evans' works, this is just fantastic and really worth every cent of it. So last but not least, one thing I'm eternally thankful for are these sketches done by Rosine Fairfield. I still don't know how to pronounce your name, actually. But he sent me the stuff a while ago. I really love how here these pencils are used for this ink drawing over there. Some messy preparation sketches, some more refined stuff. A whole slew of stuff that I've shown you in an earlier video about this gift from Rosine Fairfield to me. And he poured this creativity and imagination into one book of his, The Art of Dreaming and Drawing. And it is now available. Here you have the ISBN number. And here you have a picture of Mr. Rosine Fairfield living somewhere in France. And I recognized some of the drawings here in the book. It is about dreaming, the art of dreaming and drawing. And so he has this concept that is obviously very surrealist and goes back to the surrealists and even more into maybe 19th century illustration that already has dealt with dreaming and the importance of dreaming and how you can do lucid daydreaming, interesting ideas that he obviously came up with within some lucid daydreaming. I feel remembered by the trope of dreaming of one pretty unknown German painter, Edgar Ende, who was the father of Michael Ende, the pretty famous novelist who wrote The Neverending Story. And his father, Edgar Ende, painted surrealist paintings, and to come up with new ideas, he went into a dark room with some crayons and drew in the dark and looked for some inspiration, some stuff that came to his mind, and he doodled in the dark, and afterwards he used these dark room sketches for his paintings. Google Edgar Ende if you want to know what I'm talking about. I still haven't put out all of my art books proper in line in another room. So I looked for my old Edgar Ende exhibition catalog, but couldn't find it. But yeah, there will be videos coming up more or less soon about real artists, painters, and so on. And he obviously, Rosin, obviously used lots of different sources of inspirations for his drawings here. So, yeah, here you have even a bit of some blues Möbius-esque cartooning, and there's some Botticelli in it, and lots of different sources that he pulls from and quotes there. So I'm very curious where he goes from there, because he obviously is a younger guy, so we have a lot of stuff to look forward to in terms of his creative output. So that's all for now, folks. Thanks for listening and watching. Goodbye.